Hi, I'm Laszlo Radvanyi. I'm President and Scientific Director of the Ontario Institute for Cancer Research. I'm also a professor in the Immunology Department at the University of Toronto. And I'm here to answer your questions about cancer research and participate in Ask a Cancer Researcher.
Hi, my name is Beth Ciavaglia, and my question is, what is immunotherapy and why is it so promising?
Well, thanks, Beth. That's a very important and very pertinent question, especially now as, you know, a whole plethora of immunotherapies are making their way into the clinic and having tremendous impacts on cancer patients. And it's a question that's also very dear to my heart. So let me start by saying that we now know through many years of research, essentially, that our immune system can recognize cancer, just like it can recognize other diseases, such as viruses, for example. The problem is that a lot of times it's not a powerful enough immune response. And so what we need to do then is to, you know, give that immune system a further kick or a further help. And that's really what immunotherapy is just providing drugs and therapies that actually enhance and give that further push to the immune system to fight cancer. And there's really two classes sort of immunotherapies. One that sort of further activates the immune system against our cancer, so then giving that further push, pushing on the accelerator. But there's another class of a very exciting immunotherapies that sort of take the brakes off the immune system. Because what we've also found is that cancers have this ability to suppress our immune systems. So now we're developing another set of immunotherapies that sort of take the brakes off in addition to putting on the accelerator. So we're now able to have therapies that further activate the immune response and then drugs that actually prevent these, you know, so-called suppressive factors. And so these are sort of the main classes or the main types of agents or drugs that are in cancer patients right now. But there is even more excitement on the horizon. We can actually vaccinate patients against their cancers by basically making vaccines that contain these sort of abnormal components or things from cancer cells. And that activates a long-term sort of immune response. And so now with our ability also to detect cancer earlier, we can actually start vaccinating patients or people against cancer earlier, but also even developing vaccines that actually prevent cancer, because we can predict what sort of things the cancer will express, and then we can vaccinate and prevent cancer. So the future is very bright and very exciting.